Welcome to Blighting Party. Good afternoon, everyone. We are all here today on a very special occasion, that of the marriage of Mark and Christina. This is a day they will remember for all their lives, and we are all here to share in their happiness, to wish them well, and to make this a happy and memorable day for them both. It is traditional to be formally given in marriage on your wedding day, so now I ask, who gives Christina to be married to Mark?
I do.
Would you like to pass your daughter's hand over? And Mark, do you accept Christina's hand in marriage?
I do.
That's just as well then, isn't it? Ladies and gentlemen, if you would like to please be seated. Please have a seat. Marriage is a desire by two people to share themselves with each other, and a willingness to accept each other for who they are. For Mark and Christina, getting married today is a confirmation of the love, respect and friendship which they have for each other. Together, they will be stronger to meet whatever life holds for them. This place in which we are now all met has been duly sanctioned according to the law for the celebration of marriages. And although the civil ceremony is simple and without ritual, the vows that Mark and Christina are about to make are solemn and binding. You are all here today to witness the joining in matrimony of Mark Andrew Frampton and Christina Yolanta Schlitt. If any person present knows of any lawful impediment to this marriage, would they please declare it now? I'm not listening to you.
There's all ends with.
At this point in the ceremony, can I please ask Richard to come forward to give our first reading?
A marriage of love, spirits of minds. So unique, so easy, yet so hard to find. A marriage of harmony, telepathy too, so feeling and giving, the same point of view. A marriage of sharing, of warmth and content, so honest, so loyal, so truly meant. A marriage of travel, of laughter, of fun, so much entwined that hearts become one. A marriage for all times, for all to see, so special, so right, it just had to be.
Mark and Christina, before you are joined in matrimony, I have to remind you both of the solemn and binding character of the vows which you are about to make. Marriage in this country is the union of two people, voluntarily entered into, for life and to the exclusion of all others. In this part of the ceremony, I am now going to ask you to declare, in turn, that you know of no lawful reason why you should not be married to each other. After you have made those declarations, you will contract your marriage before your witnesses and guests gathered here today. So mark your first if you'd just like to repeat after me. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Mark Andrew Frampton.
Why I, Mark Andrew Frampton.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Christina Jolanta Split.
To Christina Jolanta Split.
Christina, if you'd just like to repeat. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know not.
That I know not.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Christina Jolanta Split.
Why I, Christina Jolanta Split.
Joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Mark Andrew Frampton.
To Mark Andrew Frampton.
Now we come to our second reading. So if I could invite Joanna to come forward, please.
So on your wedding day and every day thereafter, may your home be filled with happiness and your hearts with joy and laughter. And may each year together find you more and more in love and bring you all the happiness you're so deserving of. May the joy of true companionship be yours to share through life, and may you always treasure the day you became husband and wife.
Now the moment has come for Mark and Christina to contract their marriage before you, their guests and witnesses. I am now going to ask you to exchange the vows which will unite you in marriage. These vows are a formal and public pledge of your love and a promise of lifelong commitment to each other. So if you would like to turn to face one another, as the vows you say are to each other. And if you could repeat after me, Mark, and say them to Christina. I call upon
these persons here present
to witness that I, Mark Andrew Frampton, do take thee, Christina Jolanta Split, to be my lawful wedded wife. I call upon
these persons here present
to witness that I, Christina Jolanta Split, do take thee, Mark Andrew Frampton,
to be my lawful wedded husband.
We now come to the exchange of rings, which is the traditional way of sealing the vows which you have just made. So if I can invite them to come forward, please.
Right,
ring
first.
We've got them.
I know, it's amazing.
Not for long.
If you can place it on Christina's finger, that's not bad. And if you can hold the ring, turn to face each other. I give you this ring. As a sign of our marriage. And a symbol of our love. I pledge to you. My love and trust. I promise to be. Ever honest and faithful to you.
And to share all that I am with you.
You are my best friend. And I will always be beside you.
It's not going on.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
And a symbol of our love. I promise to laugh with you in joy.
I promise to laugh with you in joy.
To grieve with you in sorrow.
To grieve with you in sorrow.
To grow with you in love.
To grow with you.
To be faithful to you.
To be faithful to you.
And to cherish and respect you always.
And to cherish and respect you always.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
And now for his second spot in the limelight, can we ask Dan to come forward and give our third and final reading, please?
Good luck, congratulations, best wishes, cheers, well done. The future's full of promise and it's only just begun. You're starting on a journey, a new exciting life, together, as a partnership, as husband and as wife. Adventures, thrills and choices are waiting just for you. The road will have some turnings and perhaps a bump or two, but you'll be strong together. You'll come through the test. Your love will deepen week by week. Be happy. All the best.
The wedding ring is an unbroken circle. It has no beginning and no end. It symbolises unending and everlasting love and is an outward sign of the promises which you have made to each other today. This day is the start of a new phase in your life together. And we hope that the feeling of love which you have for each other today will deepen and grow ever stronger throughout the years to come. Mark and Christina, you have both made the declarations prescribed by law and have made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your witnesses, family and friends gathered here today. It now gives me the greatest of pleasure to pronounce that you are now lawfully joined in marriage together. So, Mark, would you now like to seal your marriage with a kiss?
Yes.
Not your mind. You have to was quick on the button there. Did you get that?
Did you get another kiss, Mark.
Another one. Ladies and gentlemen, do please talk amongst yourselves and listen to the lovely music while we go into the signing room, and we'll be calling through when we can to take some photos of you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be standing and attentive to receive your bride and groom.
Yes.
Now this afternoon we're breaking with tradition, so we're going to start with the speeches. It's going to be with the main man of the day, Mr. Mark Frampton.
Hello. It is traditional for the groom to make a speech thanking various people who've helped and supported the newlyweds in the run-up to the wedding and on the day itself. Some grooms opt for downloading a template speech from the internet, but to me that really is cheating, so this is all of my own work. So firstly, I would like to say a big thank you on behalf of me and insert name of bride here. Seriously though, on behalf of my wife Christina and I, welcome to our wedding celebration. We're both thrilled to share our special day with all of you, and I'm sure that everyone will agree that Chris looks absolutely stunning today.
Yes. Yeah.
Special mention must go to Chris's bridesmaid Ella and to my best man Dan for their support in getting things sorted for today. And we have a little token of appreciation for each of you. Chris, if you'd like to pass on Ella's gift. Dan, I'll wait until after your speech in case I just see I've decided he's going out to the shop.
Very wise. Yeah.
Also, thank you to our official, unofficial photographer and videographer, Adam. And thank you for everyone who's brought us wedding gifts. We look forward to spending our John Lewis vouchers and continuing to make Chris's house our home. It's very strange being here at Western Hall today, but not performing one of our murder mysteries.
Yes.
So if someone suddenly cries out and collapses dead at your table, it's nothing to do with us, and we will be seeking a discount on the food bill. Most of you are probably aware that Chris and I met online on a dating website. It was actually Chris who took the initiative and contacted me. Now, previously, when I'd been contacted online by buxom Eastern European women interested in a relationship, I'd been wary. But in this case, Chris seemed to be genuine. And indeed, we hit it off straight away.
Just wait till I get you
home. Hey! Thank you. We both share the same silly sense of humour and a love of travel. And we've been lucky enough to spend some incredible times in wonderful places such as Italy, Spain, Austria, Poland, New Zealand, Wales. We have had, as any couple does, our sad and difficult times, but also a lot of times that are full of fun and laughter. And those times that were sad or difficult have only served to bring us closer together. Chris is a very determined woman. And yes, and she has a particular project that she is working on. Me. I, on the one hand, took on a project to build a large and expensive replica of the Millennium Falcon from Star Wars. Chris, on the other hand, is trying to set a world record for the number of different lessons she can get me to take. So far, in the time that we've been together, I've had lessons that have enabled me to ski, yes. Not particularly well.
Oh, brilliant.
Play golf,
yes.
Not particularly well. Swim, yes. Not particularly well. And the latest was dance lessons.
Yes.
And in a... you wait. In a couple of hours' time, you'll be able to judge for yourself where on the scale of not particularly well I am. I know that Chris's mum has worried that she is losing a daughter.
I'm not losing her, though, my daughter.
But I can assure you, I can assure you she should be more worried about gaining me as a son-in-law. Seriously,
no,
though.
No problem there.
Seriously, though, Chris and her mum are very close, and I certainly won't be getting in the way of that special relationship. 4 years ago, Chris met my parents for the first time, and in the case of my mum, sadly, for the last time. When we were in Auckland on the day we were flying back to the UK, we met up with my parents, and both mum and dad sincerely thanked Chris for making me happy. Today, I'd like to repeat their sentiment. On our wedding day, thank you, Chris, for making me a very happy, very lucky man. Finally, as I mentioned before, we usually do murder mysteries here at Western Hall. End of September. And at the beginning of each event, we tell the guests that at the end of the night, there will be a prize for the winner. Well, tonight, it's me who is definitely the winner.
Aww.
I hope you all enjoy yourselves this evening, and thanks once again for sharing our special day.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And it was all going so well.
Yes.
It's been a wonderful day full of dignity and sobriety, and it's really time to lower the tone, actually, everybody. So for those of you who don't know me, my name is, or lucky enough not to know me, my name is Dan. The last time I looked this smart, I was probably standing in front of a jury, so I'll make the most of it while we can. When Mark asked me to be the best man, I was, of course, very flattered, followed by feeling appalled, going through a state of denial and dread. So here I am in front of you, delivering this speech. But before I get any further into it, we need to take a moment to admire our beautiful bride once again, Christina. Who looks absolutely, absolutely gorgeous. Weddings can be very stressful times, with the hissy fits and tears and the scar being strewn about the room. Mark's calmed down now. Now we can move on. It's business as usual. So Mark is clearly onto a winner with Chris, and has hit the jackpot with this beautiful, beautiful lady. I should also like to thank again our lovely bridesmaid, Ella. She's done a splendid job, looks amazing. It is, of course, customary for the best man to run off with the bridesmaid. I put my foot down, but Mark and Christina are sticklers for tradition, so, you know, what are you going to do?
I think Ruth
would
have something to say.
She might. Put the bags away. So, turning to Mark, well, we first met...
Please don't.
20 years ago.
20 years.
When this 20 years, this portly balding man in his 40s was instead a portly balding man in his 20s. We met at a drama group, the Cubbington Players, and shared our mutual love of pretending and dressing up, which we sometimes call acting. Performing in many plays together, from Shakespeare to pantomime. Mark was a drunken porter in Macbeth, Don Pedro in Much Ado About Nothing. But he was never in Midsummer Night's Dream, so we didn't get to see his bottom, which some see as a tragedy and others as a relief. We did do a play called The Herbal Bed together, where Mark's character's wife had an affair with a younger, racier man, played by me. Just throw that in there.
Look at Christina's face!
Amazing. I did meet my own wife at the same drama group on the same day that I met Mark. And sometimes it feels as though Mark and I have been in a strange kind of marriage ourselves. We did a farce together, which Mark will remember, called Funny Money, where Mark and I had to pretend to be lovers in order to escape the long arm of the law. And Mark executed a wonderfully camp performance by being just slightly less camp than normal. As a couple, we've certainly shared a few hotel rooms in our time as part of that. From my experience of sharing with Mark, I can only offer Chris my condolences. I'm not saying his snoring was loud, but the hotel guests were asking when the roadworks could start again. We have got our own partnership, as Mark has alluded to in the murder mystery business, a stab in the dark, a bit of a plug there, that was set up together, and Chris has taken a very active part in the promotional work for that. So she's used to putting a positive gloss on a bad situation. Anyway, Mark says that Chris always looks forward to a stab in the dark, so... Mark has spoken eloquently already about the lovely Christina, and I'm sure they will continue to live in wedded bliss over in Fleckney with their cat, beautiful, enormous beast called Claude. Yes, which you should
be
exactly. Of course, the Lord. So there will at least be one dominant male in the house. with plenty of hair. Mark is.
Can you just put that back in the bag?
Mark is certainly the cat that got the cream. That wasn't the original line. It was a really, really filthy line about a cat fight. On the cutting room floor. Mark and Chris are keen travellers, and I know that the long-term plan is to emigrate to the much-loved New Zealand. It's possible that Chris might even take Mark with her, so that was something we can all look forward to. So Mark and Chris are embarking on married life and all that it entails. And Chris has certainly rejuvenated the old fella.
What?
As Mark has said, through Chris's encouragement, he's taken up golf, skiing, he even took on a personal fitness trainer to enable him to scale the mountainous climbs of New Zealand last year. Unfortunately, he put his back out in the first week of training. So don't attempt anything too vigorous on honeymoon. I mean, I know Mark's looking forward to his honeymoon in Wales. He said he was looking forward to, he's going to Bangor all week. So,
That's so rude!
Maybe I got that wrong, I don't know. Horse riding is apparently another new and painful experience, with Mark becoming increasingly saddle sore as he and Chris trekked for miles. At the end of the day, the experienced rider, Chris, was fragrant and unblemished, whereas Mark was left to enormous, yet perfectly formed circles of bruising on his buttock, the likes of which he hasn't seen since his private school days. Bagging for the senior boys. Mark does have interests of his own. He's had an endearing obsession with science fiction.
Oh, yeah.
I'm surprised we're not all tied in Star Wars outfits, stormtroopers, Jedi Knights, maybe Princess Leia, Yoda.
This he didn't say Jabba the Hutt.
He knows every incarnation of Doctor Who and what TARDIS stands for, and he's even adopted a line that appeared on his own dating website: "Don't worry, it's much bigger on the inside." Mark and I can make fun of each other simply because he's such a great friend, and he's one of the funniest. I've written it down here, so it was true. He's one of the funniest, talented, best guys you could wish to meet. He's a great impressionist and a comic talent. I can say, hand on heart, that next to Mark, I've always felt like the straight man. Our friendship has taken on a perpetual carry-on film version for over 20, as you can probably gather, for about 20 years. I'm becoming more like Charles Hawtrey and Mark Barbara Windsor, until he gets his personal trainer back on the scene. I mentioned science fiction earlier, and it's clear Mark has saved his best and most exciting adventure for last. He's found great happiness with Chris, another wonderful, talented and beautiful person. Of course we wish them luck, but they don't need it, because they're made for each other and will make each other happier and stronger. So, joking aside, it is an absolute honour to be a part of your special day and to count such an excellent couple as my close friends. So, ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for your toast. Give you, ladies and gentlemen, the bride and groom.
The bride and groom.
Stolat. Nazdravje.
Stolat. Stolat. Niech żyje nam. Stolat. Stolat. Niech żyje, żyje nam. Jeszcze raz, jeszcze raz. Niech żyje, żyje nam. Niech żyje nam.
Please take a seat.
Okay.
Wait.
Oh. I don't know where we're supposed to cut it.
Let's cut it in the middle.
Hold on. Okay, alright. Ready?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Whoa! Whoa!
Well, that deserves applause.
First one. Then we're going to try and fill the floor, and everybody get on the floor. We're going to play a few waltzy old timers just for you guys tonight. And one special thing, of course.
Or is your game made of this? Don't forget a small relief. Fall in lightly with a dream. The old lips and mine, two sips of wine. Memories are made of this. days. These are the dreams you will save. With his blessings from above,
you can't be the memories you gave.
Serve it generously with love.
You can't be the memories you gave.
One man, one wife, one love, true life, man,
sweet, sweet,
the reincarnation we
live.
Can be the memory
of man,
the
so.
With maybe it's
not letting me.
It's good. You ready, guys? Come on, let's make some noise then. Everybody sing.
Stare lassù e volavo, volavo, venice con alte del sole col coro più su, mentre modo pian piano e sparivo lontano laggiù. Una musica dolce suonare soltanto per me. Sing. Your love has given me wings. Nel blu, dipinto del blu.
Venite. Okay, guys, give you one more time. And we will slip one single waltzes in the next one, right? In the meantime.
When I was just a little girl, I asked my mother, what will I be? She said to me,
everybody,
que sera, sera. Whatever will be, will be.
Come on, you guys,
the future's not ours.
Let's try and fill
the floor
tonight.
Que sera, sera. What will be, will be. When I grew up and fell in love, I asked my sweetheart what lies ahead. Whatever will be, the future's not ours.